one of the best kept secrets of the industry was that this stuff was killing people who were directly involved with handling it. Even though in the 1930s, there's definite concern amongst the medical professionals that they could put two and two together, but they didn't know very much about how it was happening and what was causing it. It wasn't until Irving Selikoff applied the scientific method. So you have a hypothesis, you test that hypothesis experimentally, you do statistics, and then you publish it all in peer-reviewed medical journals. He said, people are getting asbestos disease from inhaling fibers, and they're getting it from inhaling this many fibers. And this is how long it's taking to develop disease. He put it all together and blew the top off of the big secrecy that was going on in the industry. When this information came in from Selikoff, the question started to be asked, how do we protect these people? That led to all the regulations in the late 70s that popped up, and the asbestos products started to be banned. Exposure limits came into play. And so the regulations started coming into play. And we suddenly had, oh, this stuff is terrible. We have to protect these people. We have to have respirators. We have to have protective clothing. We have to have procedures to protect people who are outside of these areas. And we have to dispose of this stuff properly.